Hey guys, Pablo with BND, and today at Top Reddit Post, we're gonna be taking a look at choosing beggars. And if you haven't subscribed yet, don't forget to do so, hit that notifications button, and leave a comment and a like in the end of our video. CB Vulture, picking over my dead mom's belongings. So, I unfortunately lost my mom 4 weeks ago today. Sadly, my mom didn't own her home, nor did she have much money. So while clearing out her place, which she recently decorated on a budget and furnished, I have been listing her belongings on Facebook Marketplace to raise money for her ashes to be interred. CB messaged me on Friday wanting to buy her desktop printer. Fine. However, it was my mom's funeral on Friday, so I didn't read and reply, obviously. He keeps on sending me more messages through the day to get me to reply. He's keen and not to know I'm at my mom's funeral, so I ignored him. I finally reply on Saturday. It's £15 for a fairly new 45-pound Epson printer. He agrees he wants it, and we arrange for him to collect from my mom's today. As I'm here again, doing more sorting and cleaning, he texts me to say he's on his way and adds, £10 okay? No dude, not okay. It's £15. He arrives and I tell him it's £15. He starts pulling a face. I'm like, as you can see, this is an old people's accommodation, not my house. I've lost my mom and raising money to bury her, so it's £15. The software is all there unopened. It's good as new. He very reluctantly pays up and asks what other things I'm selling. So I show him around. He says he likes a beautiful side table and asks how much. I say £20. He replies, but can I have it for free? I repeat that sadly not. I'm raising money to bury my mom, remember? He then starts poking around all my mom's belongings and asks, so what is here that I can have for free then? Absolutely nothing, you vulture. Go away. I didn't say that, as I was, of course, terribly British, and apologized that nothing was for free. To be honest, anything that is left will go to a deserving local charity. Not a choosing beggar. He took his printer and left. Added, I completely forgot to add that when he went to pay me, he pulled out a wad of about £300 of 20 pound notes, just to add insult to injury. Hey guys, what's funny is that the more people have sometimes, the more they seem to want a break. Give me part of inheritance. So, my grandfather passed away a few years ago and grandmother was left with the house and 3 acres of land to her name. Few months later, my grandmother's half-brother, whose wife was also dead, sold his apartment in the city and moved with my grandmother to help her out, as they were very close since I can't remember. Our families used to be very close and my grandma's brother was super nice and a cool guy. It's just that I never had much contact with his grandchildren as they were living the other side of the country. Last year, my grandmother also passed, and me and my 2 brothers were each left with 1 acre of land to our names, and the house was left for me. Since we're all very close, we let my grandmother's brother to continue living there, since after selling his apartment, he really didn't have anywhere to go, and he didn't want to move to the other side of the country with his kids. Not to mention, the house itself had almost no value, and there were other houses in the village that were standing on the market for years with no interest. So comes this spring and my grandma's brother also passed away, and it's during the funeral where the absurd begins. I was smoking outside the church when his grandson comes and immediately goes down to business. Conversation went as something as follows. So, what about inheritance? What do you mean? My grandpa's part? Didn't he bought you a car and gave you money for a down payment of your apartment? Yeah, but he sold his apartment and gave me money. It was inheritance. I'm talking about inheritance of the house and lands where he lived. Well, the house and the lands belonged to my grandparents. Your grandfather had nothing to do with it. You can feel him getting irritated. But my grandfather lived here, so surely it also belonged to him. We let him live there because he didn't want to move. He never had any ownership. But what about all the help he gave to your grandmother? Surely he deserves some reward for being so helpful. Doesn't change anything. The house and the lands belongs to us for more than a year now, since it was my grandmother's. He deserves a part of the inheritance, and I'll be demanding my rightful part. Dude, you got your part when your grandpa sold his apartment and gave almost everything to you and your mom. He lived here, so the part also belongs to him and his family, and we'll be making a claim. Dude, there's no claim to make. The inheritance is already claimed. We'll see about that. And it's been a few months now, and he's been bothering us on Facebook and on the phone about how we stole his inheritance. He just recently wrote an SMS, remind us that we're thieves. I was browsing Reddit, and I thought I should make a post about it. I'm at loss of words, man. I mean, it sucks when you have your family try to thief you. Just need to buy some food for my kids. I was told to post this here based on my comments on r/humanbeingbros. I was contacted by a childhood friend who I heard had some drug issues. She told me that she had her kids, but had nothing in the way of food to send for school lunches for next week. She was worried that if she sent the kids to school without lunch, that someone would report her to CAS again. I told her I would help her out. I went to the grocery store and bought enough cookies, fruit snacks, juice boxes, bread and bologna to last 3 kids a whole week. I even threw in a box of cereal and a bag of milk. I didn't have any money, so I used my credit card to pay for the stuff. Only about 35 bucks, so not a huge deal. I went to her house to drop off the food. She was completely upset that I brought over food and not cash. I explained that I didn't have cash and it was easier to just buy the stuff with my credit card. She got even more mad and said that I could have just taken the cash from the credit card at any bank machine. It appeared that her children weren't even there. She didn't talk to me for years after that. She ended up losing custody of her kids to her mother, and then she moved in with her mother. So she's still with her kids, but their care is left up to grandma. Update: the kids are doing just fine. I moved down the road from then. It's a super small town. They hang out with my kids and they look happy and healthy. Hey guys, I'm just saying, say no to drugs, because some people, they really can't handle that stuff and they'll take from their own kids for drugs and alcohol, so be very careful, okay? I'm not saying I'm against 420 or that stuff, I'm just saying, if you can't handle what you do, just don't do it. It can be alcohol, it can be anything, even cigarettes. But my commission. I work for HR, I had an employee call in. This is how the conversation went.
Yeah, my boss saw that I've been really sick, and since I don't have sick time available, he was nice enough to give me this week off without it hurting my job. Also, next week I'll go on short-term disability. What does that cover?
That's very nice of your boss to assist you with days off. Now, short-term disability will cover 50% of what you are currently making.
But I'll get paid for this week? I mean, I didn't ask my boss to give me the time off. It was his recommendation that I do so. So, will I see the pay on my check? And what about my commission when I'm on short-term disability?
You will need to contact your manager regarding this week's pay. But if he gave you time off, it means it's time off without pay, without getting trouble for not showing up to work. Also, you mentioned you didn't have sick time, and I see you do not have vacation time either. You need to partner with your supervisor about pay. I was basically hinting his boss was nice enough to give him time off when he didn't have any time and he shouldn't expect pay. As for the commission, we do not pay for the commission, as that is something you get for sales you make and not part of your actual wage.
What? You can't just look what I've made in commission over the last few months and give me half of that?
No, sir. You get 50% of your current wage and commission is not part of it.
Well, that's not right. I'll have to talk to my manager. I don't think you know what you're talking about. Oh my God, some people are just dumb. I mean, commission has to do with sales. It doesn't matter what job you do. I think even a 5 years old know that. And the guy wants 50% of the average of sales he did. That's just insane. I mean, one thing is be a choosing beggar and the other thing is needing professional help. Hey guys, I really hope you guys liked this video. If you did, don't forget to leave a thumbs up, a comment, and subscribe to the channel. And I'll be seeing you guys again tomorrow. And I hope you guys have a great end of your day.